South African athletics finds itself in a sublime space. The Olympics in Rio set the tone as Wade van Niekerk, Caster Semenya and Luvu Manyonga stole the show in the Rainbow Nations best medal haul since readmission to international sport in 1992. The trend continued in London at the World Championships. Therefore, it was no surprise that the trio were nominated for athletics' top prize.
We've had a fantastic year from all sorts of levels, but this is the cream of South African athletics. So it's also well deserved. You know, two of them, it's a calendar year winning streak. Caster's more than that. Luvo is a calendar year of beating every single person that he's come up against.
Banyonga's coach Neil Cornelius is thrilled that the Olympic silver medalist has been recognized for his achievements and is proud of the man who has overcome so much to realize his true potential and reach the summit of the long jump event.
That wasn't even part of my goals for this year. Because we wanted to dominate the long jump, but with Luvo being compared with athletes of other events, guys like Mo Farah and Wade, it's unbelievable. It's crazy. I mean, these guys think Luvo is on the same level as the world record holder, as the European record holders. You know, he is not just a good long jumper, but they see him as a good athlete.
Although the future appears bright for athletics in South Africa, there remains room for improvement in order for the country that boasts three world champions to be adding more gold to its ever-growing tally.
I think, you know, South Africa is in a good space, but we need to kind of look at, you know, where do we kind of, you know, bulk it up a bit. We need a little bit more depth in certain events, especially, you know, more of our kind of field events and some of our distance events, middle distance events.
The process to establish the men's and women's winners is broken down into three votes. Fans get a say on the IAAF's social media platforms. That counts for 25%, while the IAAF's council votes will have a 50% say. The IAAF families vote is a further 25% before the winners are announced on November 24th. Regardless of the outcome, though, South Africa's golden trio deserve to be recognized for what has been a stellar year in athletics. CS du Plessis, CGTN, Johannesburg.